Good evening. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 46th annual State of the City Address. Now, this is a moment of celebration. This is our first State of the City Address in the Riverside Convention Center since January 2020. Now, that is cause for celebration. I am pleased to announce that we have over 1,000 guests here joining us this evening. Now, that means that if we have 1,000 guests, that means we probably have about 1,200 cell phones out there. So I'm going to ask you all to use this as an opportunity to silence your cell phone at this moment in time so that it doesn't disturb our program. Before we begin our program, we have to obviously take care of something that's very important. As you all know, in Riverside County, we lost two deputies in the line of duty, Deputy Isaiah Cordero, Deputy Darnell Calhoun, and obviously those are immense tragedies for our region and for our community. But of course, as Californians, we know that we have neighboring communities, fellow communities across the state that are also experiencing their own recent tragedies. This is something that we should all band together as one community, as one state, as one region, as one nation. So I'd ask you all to join me for a brief moment of silence and compassion for the lives lost. Thank you. To lead today's invocation, we have a collection of leaders representing a diverse community of faiths here in Riverside. Joining us is the Very Reverend Rafael Partida of the Diocese of San Bernardino, Rabbi Shmuel Fuss of the Shabbat Jewish Community Center of Riverside, Pastor Iki Tami of the La Sierra University Church of Seventh-day Adventists, and Dr. Mahmoud Harmoush of the Islamic Center of Riverside. Gentlemen.
Please rise and join me in reflection. The Bible relates that when the great ruler King Solomon ascended the throne, God appeared to him in a dream and said, "Request what I shall give to you." Solomon made a single request from God, and I quote, "May you grant your servant an understanding heart to judge your people, that I may distinguish between good and evil." God was pleased and said, "Because you have requested this and you have not requested anything else, behold, I have given you a wise and understanding heart. And even that which you did not request, I have granted you both riches and honor." Dear God, we pray to you today that these divine words be fulfilled for our city leaders who fulfill one of the seven Noahide commandments to govern by just laws. May you bless our mayor, Patricia Locke Dawson, the city council, our new city manager, our police and fire chiefs, and all of our city officials with wisdom to have ears to hear, eyes to see, hearts to feel, and hands to help, so that great things can continue to happen in this great city of Riverside. And let us say, amen.
Loving and gracious God, we give you thanks for the rich diversity of peoples and cultures who make up the city of Riverside. Bless our communities with peaceful unity, that we may work with our various gifts, talents, and skills to build a society that lives in harmony. Enable us to recognize the rich heritage of each culture and peoples, knowing that each brings a gift to our city. Together we can discover the beauty and potential of our city so that we can overcome the hurts and pains and more so achieve our hopes and dreams for Riverside. May your blessing accompany us in our endeavors for justice and peace, Give us the courage and will to love and respect each other with compassion and understanding. Enable us to listen to each other so that each one can know that they are respected and valued. Thus, can each of us desire to contribute to the harmony and unity of our city. Bring wisdom to our city leaders. Grant them the insights they need to serve all the peoples who have entrusted the city to their care. Let the city's leadership find joy and comfort in their service to the community. And as it is said in Psalms 33, verse 12, blessed are the people whose God is the Lord. So with confidence and thanksgiving, we entrust the city of Riverside to your care, in Christ Jesus, the Prince of Peace. Amen.
Let us continue in prayer. God, whose very strength sutured the fabric of this universe together from chaos, and whose love redeemed humanity's course that we might live in divine service for each other, forgive us for being distracted by the cacophonous voices from the true work of building together humankind with human kindness. Tonight, O Lord, we ask for strength. Grant our leaders strength that fortifies character, restraint, and goodness for all. A strength that can withstand the discomfort of doing right when wrong seems most profitable. A strength to listen and hear the needs of their community, especially those most vulnerable among us. And a strength to lead us into the uncharted waters of the future while holding us all together from Ward 1 to Ward 7. Finally, Lord, grant us residents here as well, of this great city's strength. Give us the strength to believe in each other, to stand for each other, to care for each other, the businessman and the student, the resident and the professional, all together to look beyond oneself, seeing the needs of our neighbor, to work that we may all grow and flourish here in the city of Riverside. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory. Amen.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Lord God, the merciful, the compassionate. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May God peace and blessing be upon you all. Dear Mayor, City Council, brothers and sisters of the city of Riverside, friends and families, I am here in behalf of the Islamic Center of Riverside and the Muslim community to wish you all a happy, prosperous, and peaceful new year. In the recent events of violence in our states and around the country, I really strongly believe that this is a reminder for all of us to open our hearts for the message of peace that comes from the heavenly teaching of the prophets of God, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad, peace be upon them all. I pray that we all work harder this year to accomplish peace and harmony in our society, in our city, in our state, in our country, and all over the world. And may God bless you, protect you, and save you, all those who serve and protect and help each other in this world. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Now for today's national anthem, please welcome from La Sierra University, Tashiana Simpson.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early? so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. So gallantly streaming, and the rockets rocking, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there.
Tashiana, clear your calendar, because I think we're going to invite you back. Thank you. To lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, please welcome from Matthew Gage Middle School, Edison Kanatsar.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. Please put your right hand over your heart. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Thank you, Edison. Now, it's going to be a great evening, and we encourage you to follow along with us on social media, and even post if you have the means to. If you do, make sure you use the hashtags RIVSOTC or RIVBiz in your posts as you join the conversation. At this time, I'd like to recognize our platinum level sponsors. Now, you may review your program for the full list of our generous supporters, but you all as an audience know, and I'm sorry, you may take your seats. So excited to get started here. Sorry about that. Now, please hold your applause until all of our supporters have been announced. Albert A. Webb Associates, Altura Credit Union, Alvord Unified School District, AMPAC Tri-State, Athens Services, Best Best and Krieger, California Baptist University, Canyon Springs Marketplace, Chase Bank, the Cheech Marin Center for Chicano Art and Culture of the Riverside Art Museum, Citizens United for Resources and the Environment, Fenimore Law, Hillwood Investment Properties, Lamar Advertising, Northgate Market, OPR Communications, Realm Group, Regional Properties, Riverside City Firefighters Association, Riverside Community Hospital, Riverside Community Services Foundation, Riverside County Office of Economic Development, Riverside County Office of Education, Riverside Fire Management Group, Team Logic IT Riverside, Tilt and Coil Constructors, and the University of California Riverside A. Gary Anderson Graduate School of Management. Thank you all for your support. It is my pleasure to introduce our honored guests today. And I'd ask all of them, as they're called, to please stand and be recognized. And to the audience, again, you know the drill. Please hold your applause until all have been introduced. Representing Western Municipal Water District, Gracie Torres, Fawzia Rizvi, President Mike Gardner, and General Manager Craig Miller. Alvord Unified School District Board of Education members Georgina Ramirez, Lizeth Vega, and President Robert Schwant. Riverside Unified School District Board of Education members Tom Hunt, President Dr. Angelo Farouk, and Superintendent Renee Hill. Riverside Community College District Board of Trustees Jose Alcala, Virginia Blumenthal, and Mary Figueroa. University of California Riverside Chancellor Kim Wilcox. City of Riverside Council members Clarissa Cervantes, Ronaldo Fierro, Chuck Conder, and Steve Hemingway, and our new city manager, Mike Fatrell. Welcome, Mike. Oh, you're supposed to wait. City of Moreno Valley Mayor Ulysses Cabrera. City of Paris Mayor Michael Vargas. Riverside County Auditor and Controller Ben Benoit. Representing the County of Riverside Supervisorial District 1, Supervisor Kevin Jeffries. Representing the 31st Senate District, State Senator Richard Roth. And Chair of the Chamber and AT&T External Affairs Director and Tribal Liaison, Julio Figueroa. And of course, our very special guest this evening, the Mayor of the City of Riverside, Patricia Locke Dawson, and her husband, Scott. Now the Chamber is also pleased to host very special guests, and that are students from the Riverside Youth Council, California Baptist University, La Sierra University, Riverside City College, and the University of California Riverside. Now these are the individuals that are likely to be our next mayor, our next Chamber of Commerce president, or our future Riverside Hero Award. So please welcome them. Students, thank you for being here. Now I'd like to recognize some of our gold sponsors. Alabassi Construction and Engineering, American Medical Response, Associated Builders and Contractors Southern California Chapter, Bank of America, Burtech Waste Industries, California State University San Bernardino, Chevron Canyon Crest Car Wash, Farmhouse Collective, The Grove Community Church, Inland Empire Community Foundation, Inland Empire Health Plan, and Kaiser Permanente Riverside Medical Center. Thank you all for your support. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as a reminder, we have a bar that's available at the back of the room, so please make sure you get your drinks before we start the mayor's speech, and we are forced to close it down. Now to present the beautification awards, please welcome the Keep Riverside Clean and Beautiful Board Chair Brenda Flores and Executive Director Connie Lieberneck.
Thank you, Nick. This part of the program was established to recognize businesses and institutions that best represent the spirit of keeping Riverside beautiful. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the members of the Keep Riverside Clean and Beautiful Advisory Board who helped make this program a success. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you. And now, it's my pleasure to present the winners of this year's Beautification Awards. Please hold your applause until the finalists in each category have been announced.
Welcome to the 2023 Beautification Awards. Sponsored by Keep Riverside Clean and Beautiful. Photographs by Michael J. Elderman Photography and Brenda Flowers Photography. Video presentation by Milestone Media, filmtovideo.com. In the category of small business beautification, third place, Magnolia Heating and Cooling. Second place, Mundial Coffee. First place, Beignet Spot.
Accepting awards are Eric Smith from Magnolia Heating and Cooling, Priscilla Horta and Nayeli Aceradas from Mundial Coffee, and Angela and Carlo Alce from the Beignet Spot. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes. On to the next category.
Maintenance of existing facilities and landscaping. place, Canyon Crest Town Center. Second place, Smiley Periodontics and Dental Implants, Dr. Mohammed Hassan. First place, University of California, Riverside, Student Success Center.
Accepting awards are Emily Potts from Canyon Crest Town Center, Dr. Mohammed Hassan from Smiley Periodontics and Dental Implants, and Jacqueline Norman from the University of California, Riverside, the Student Success Center. Congratulations. Thank you all. The next category.
Exterior reconstruction with landscaping. Third place, Aimee Paw. Second place, Calaveras RS Inc. First place, Stater Brothers Markets, store number 207.
Accepting awards are Ruben Bedagon from Aimee Paw, Lillian Brito and Sarita Ocampo from Calaveras Restaurant, and Victoria Vildesola from Stater Brothers Markets. Congratulations, thank you. Okay.
That's okay.
Congratulations to them. Now for the next category.
New construction with landscaping. Third place, Olivewood Memorial Park, C.O. Parayan Memorial Mausoleum. Second place, California Baptist University, soccer and softball fields. First place, Quick Quack Car Wash.
Accepting awards are Robert Brown from Olivewood Memorial Park, Kent Dacus from California Baptist University, softball and soccer fields, and Philip Trotter from Quick Quack Car Wash. Congratulations, gentlemen. Thank you. Now to the next award.
Sustainable design and innovation. Housing the most advanced emissions testing and research facilities in the world, this property maintains a LEED Platinum certification as the largest net zero energy structure in the nation. Every aspect of the architecture reflects the groundbreaking research within as an epicenter of air quality and innovation in California. California Air Resources Board, Southern California headquarters.
Accepting on behalf of the California Air Resource Board, Southern California headquarters, Leanne Randolph. Thank you. This way. Now to the next one.
Historic and cultural preservation. The property that formerly housed the main library in downtown Riverside found new life and revived significance as a focal point for artistic expression and cultural celebration. Now the home of a new world-class museum, it has been beautifully restored to its original formalism architectural style of 1965. This serves as a rare yet excellent example of civic architecture of the past, combining with innovation of today to create a lifelong love of the arts for the future. The Cheech Marin Center for Chicano Art and Culture of the Riverside Art Museum.
Yes. Accepting on behalf of the Cheech Marin Center for Chicano Art and Culture, Ophelia Valdez-Yeager, Drew Oberzerge, and Esther Fernandez. Congratulations. Now to the next award.
Chairman's Award. There is a new conference center at 3939 13th Street to manage the support services for the educational, financial, and credential objectives for the county's K-12 teachers. Additions include a three-level parking structure, additional office space, a top-level outside deck, a new cafe, and space to hold 400 conference attendees for a single event. Riverside County Office of Education.
Accepting on behalf of the Riverside County Office of Education, Dr. Edwin Gomez. Congratulations, sir. Congratulations again. Now to the next award.
Mayor's Award. The exciting concept of sustainable urban farming has been established on the Riverside City College campus as a new outdoor classroom, plant laboratory, and greenhouse. The project is located in the heart of the campus and demonstrates the commitment the school is making to environmental justice and sustainable stewardship for future generations. Riverside City College, Outdoor Plant Laboratory.
Accepting on behalf of Riverside City College, Virginia White. There you go. Congratulations, Virginia. Now to the final award.
Award of Distinction. One of Riverside's newest additions to the relevance of the region. Mission Heritage Plaza. A dream come true for Rose Mays with equality for all. It's a 3-in-1 for the property that will now celebrate civil rights, keep history alive, and provide additional housing for the community. Mission Heritage Plaza, Fair Housing Council of Riverside County, and Civil Rights Institute of Inland Southern California.
Accepting for the Mission Heritage Plaza, Fair Housing Council of Riverside County, and Civil Rights Institute of Inland Southern California, Rose Mays and Sabrina Gonzalez. Congratulations, Sabrina. Congratulations. On behalf of Keep Riverside Clean and Beautiful, congratulations to all the award recipients for keeping Riverside beautiful. Let's give our winners one more round of applause. Thank you. And now, back to you, Nick.
Thank you, Connie, and congratulations again to all of our Beautification Award recipients. Now I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our remaining gold sponsors. La Sierra University, Neighborhood Housing of the Inland Empire, PNC Bank, Provident Bank, Riverside Community College District, Riverside Convention Center, Riverside Medical Clinic, Riverside Public Utilities, Ruth Villalobos and Associates, Shrine Group, Southern California Edison, University of California Riverside, Valley Vista Services, Varner and Brandt, Verizon Wireless, and Western Municipal Water District. Thank you to all of our gold sponsors. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we all know that innovation is the path to Riverside's future. To introduce our inaugural Riverside Innovation Award and tonight's recipient, please welcome for the first time Mayor Patricia Locke Dawson.
You know, Riverside prides itself on being the city of arts and innovation. And some take this motto as their life's mission. And to honor those who go above and beyond to make Riverside a city that is vibrant, innovative, and attractive, this year I established something new, the Innovation Award. When thinking of the criteria for this award, I immediately thought of a person who fit perfectly. Someone who survived the Holocaust, emigrated to America in the late 1940s, and later found his way to Southern California. He saw Riverside of the 1970s and saw potential for a world-class city. And over the next 5 decades, he built Riverside, never cutting corners and always pushing the envelope with new, exciting, and innovative approaches to development. His ambitious approach to development changed the face of Riverside from Mission Grove to downtown and everywhere in between. And although he passed away nearly 2 years ago, his wife Pam and their children continue his great legacy, most recently with the grand opening of the MARC mixed-use development just a few blocks from us. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present the inaugural City of Riverside Innovation Award for 2023 to Mark Rubin. And to accept the award, on behalf of her father and as president of Regional Properties, please welcome Mark's daughter, Michelle Rubin.
Thank you all. Please be seated. I just saw a picture of my dad. Can someone bring that up again, please? Or maybe I'll cry. Hi, Dad. Notice he had his Riverside pin on. I don't even have one of those. How do I get one of those? I guess I got to be around another 47 years. Thank you. This is a tremendous honor. I do have to make, my mom is alive and well. And at an event in the desert for UC Riverside, Jewish Studies program, which the chair is named the Mark and Pam Rubin Chair in Jewish Studies, so she's, UCR took her away tonight. But on behalf of the Rubin family and Regional Properties, I cannot thank the mayor enough for this tremendous honor. My father loved this city more than anything, and I don't say that lightly. For those of you who are able to be on Zoom for his burial, my sister had this line. My father had three loves in his life: his family, his friends, and the city of Riverside, but not necessarily in that order. And I honestly believe that my father, if he were here, he is here tonight, he's just not physically here with us, would thank all of you, especially the city, the people who work in City Hall, the Chamber, for all that they do for the city. So on behalf of Regional Properties, my nephew flew in, the oldest grandchild, flew in from New York. Thank you, Aaron, for being here. My brother is photographing in the middle. I have my CFO and my COO, who are only part-time employees, 32 and 23 years with our company, and dear friends who have made my dad's vision a reality. And the MARC is coming online next month. And that was my dad's last project that he developed in the city of Riverside. That was his last, but not our last, as the Rubin family. Thank you.
Congratulations, Michelle. Your father truly was an amazing man. Now for the introduction of the Riverside Hero Award. Please welcome the External Affairs Director and Tribal Liaison for AT&T, as well as Chair of the Chamber's Board of Directors, Julio Figueroa.
There you go. Let's get this up here, Nick. Good evening, Riverside. Buenas tardes. Before I get into my comments, congratulations again to the winner so far. Thank you for the contributions you're making to business and quality of life here in Riverside. So appreciate everything and all your contributions you're making. Again, before I go into my comments, I would like to respectfully acknowledge and recognize our responsibility to the original and current caretakers of this land, water, and air. The Cahuilla, the Tongva, Luiseno, and Serrano peoples, and all their ancestors and descendants, past, present, and future. Today, this meeting place is home to many indigenous people from all over the world, and we are grateful to have the opportunity to live and work on these homelands. For almost 30 years, the Chamber has presented the Hero Award to a group or individual who has made a significant contribution to promote Riverside at the state or national level during the past year. Tonight's recipient is a world-famous actor and comedian that rose to prominence as half of the Cheech and Chong comedy duo during the 1970s and early 80s. But in addition to his long and successful career in movies and television, we celebrate tonight his ability to showcase diverse Chicano culture and heritage. His creative efforts have established Riverside as a well-known destination for arts and culture. Featuring a 700-piece collection, this recipient has brought a unique asset to our community through the largest collection of Chicano art in the world. Muchas gracias, Cheech. This exhibition of paintings, sculpture, photography, and video art is estimated to have a $23 million economic impact each year in Riverside. And it is projected to have a $300 million economic benefit over the course of the next 10 years. In addition, he has helped to revitalize a treasured historic building and create a new draw for visitors and patrons in downtown Riverside. For this outstanding achievement, it is my honor, es mi placer, Cheech, to present this year's Riverside Hero Award to the Cheech Marin Center for Chicano Art and Culture and to the man behind the vision, Cheech Marin.
Thank you very much. I'm a little under the weather today. My doctor said that 3 weeks ago that I had bronchitis. I don't even like the Broncos. I mean, so, you know, Ramitis or Raideritis, I could do. But I really wanted to come here tonight because I wanted to thank all the people involved to have made the Cheech the rousing success that it is today. It's beyond my wildest dreams and expectations. I want to thank Julio Figueroa, the Greater Riverside Chamber of Commerce, and Mayor Patricia Locke Dawson for this award. She's doing a great job, and I hope she stays in office for quite a while. I would also like to thank the City Council leadership for believing in the importance of exhibiting and uplifting Chicano art, and for all the Chicanos in the audience. There you go, one in the corner. Thank you very much. I would also like to thank the Riverside Art Museum Board of Trustees and staff for taking this challenge. When the City of Riverside approached you all and me, who knew then what would be accomplished in nearly 6 short years, which according to their estimates is warp speed in museum time, that we've gotten this from idea to inception to opening the doors. I'd like to thank so many of you here who have visited the Cheech and donated to the Cheech and become members of the museum. Just 2 weeks ago, I bought 27 members of my family, and boy, that was a mob to come and say we have a whole flock of new little kids, and they behave for the first times in their lives. I'm happy to share that as of yesterday, and this is the first time anybody's going to hear this, that we have nearly 87,000 visitors to the Cheech in less than 6 months. We are on track to exceed the city's projections of 100,000 visitors. We're going to trample on that. These visitors have stayed in the Riverside hotels, eaten at Riverside restaurants, and filled their gas tanks with Riverside gas. So many people across the nation are learning about Riverside as an arts destination. I better take off my glasses. I just recently been diagnosed with CSS. Can't see shit. Oh, with fellow people. Did you know that at least 533 news features on the center since May have come out in media across the nation and in the world? And we are the ones who have, and those are just the ones we have tracked it. And also, just recently, we have been named one of the top 50 art museum, art shows in 2022, one of the top 50 in the world. And so we're very proud of that. And it's all, and every time I get up there, I say that we're here in Riverside, California. Have you tried our Riverside gas? It's really good. It's an amazing feat that has been accomplished, and because the art is good and is part of America, and it is American art and defines who we are as a people to come together and gather and enjoy art from the heart of the artists who have created this. They have described the Chicano experience in 1,000 different shades of brown, from our most obvious political stances to our most intimate private moments. The Cheech is a symbol of pride and what a community can accomplish when it comes together. And you, the people of Riverside, have made this happen with your continued support. And from the bottom of my heart, I really thank you. Thank you very much.
Congratulations again to Cheech and the team at Riverside Art Museum. Now I'd like to introduce our speaker to deliver tonight's State of the City. She was elected the mayor of Riverside in November 2020 after a distinguished career championing issues of conservation, education, and mental health. Her experience ranges from a small business owner to public service at virtually every level of government, ranging from local school board to working with the U.S. Bureau of Land Management. Across all of these roles, she remains committed to championing passionate issues, including delivering mental health services to those in need and preserving and cultivating the Santa Ana River. But before I welcome her on stage, let's catch up on a few of the latest happenings happening across the city from the last year. Please enjoy this brief video. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and privilege to welcome the 18th mayor of the city of Riverside, your mayor, Patricia Locke Dawson.
Thank you. Hey, good evening, Riverside. And guess what? We're live! We're back, baby! We're back after 3 years of hiatus, and this is my first State of the City in person. Yeah. I am so excited to be here tonight. Thank you all for coming, and I do also want to thank our council members. I think I see here we've got, well, even if they're not here, let's just thank them. I've got Aaron Edwards, I got Clarissa Cervantes, Ronaldo Fierro, Chuck Condor, Gabby Placencia, Jim Perry, and Steve Hemingway I saw out there too. I want to thank you all for your commitment and service and being great colleagues to work with. Thank you so much. And a heartfelt thank you to the very best chamber in California. Thank you to the Greater Riverside Chambers of Commerce for hosting this event every year, virtual or not, and in particular, President and CEO Nick Adcock. This is a big night for him too. It's his first one too. And welcome aboard Mike Futrell, our new city manager, who joined us just a few weeks ago. And Mike, thank you for choosing Riverside, and I'm really looking forward to what we can do for Riverside working together. So thank you for being here. And most important, though, what I'd really like to do is thank all of you, our residents, our businesses, our educational institutions, our nonprofit organizations, and our community partners. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for allowing me the honor and privilege of serving my hometown as mayor. Thank you. Oh, you know, last year's State of the City really looked a little different than what I'd hoped for. And no doubt, we've all faced challenges. But I'm happy and confident to say that we're here tonight to tell you what the state of the city is, and I'm here to tell you the state of Riverside is spectacular. We are positioned for investment, opportunity, and prosperity. Riversiders, we are resilient, ready for action, and committed to designing a better tomorrow. Our theme, Riverside by Design, draws on the basic definition of design, which you can all see on the screen. To create, fashion, execute, or construct according to plan. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to design a Riverside that works for all of us. Now, plans and designs usually require timelines, so I thought what I would do is share with you some of our work that we've done in the past couple years through a timeline and go over some dates and milestones. So let's kick it off with that. Let's start with December of 2020. Well, we all remember 2020. I'm sure many of us would like to forget 2020. And I was fortunate enough, of course, to inherit an exceptionally easy year as mayor, not so much, but that never slowed us down. We worked from day one. In July of 2021, we launched the mayor's big tent tour in La Sierra. I know, I'm looking at Steve Hemingway. In La Sierra. We started in La Sierra on purpose to engage residents in places most comfortable and convenient for them. Now, these 14 meetings that we had across the city were in our major neighborhoods, and they were designed to essentially bring City Hall to the people and empower residents to identify what is working and what is not working in their city. In October of 2021, we launched the Mayor's Bipartisan Forum. The forum comprises 14 community members with very different political ideologies, who have come together to tackle the intractable problems of our day. And I am a firm believer that when you have people of different viewpoints, you have a more robust decision-making process. And the forum was instrumental
in supporting legislation to modernize the state's approaches to mental health care. Now, in January of 2022, we received $4.4 million to launch our Youth Job Corps. And in May of 2022, we raised $200,000 in private donations to redesign our Military Wall of Honor and Veterans Plaza. Thank you for your support. And also, I just want to take a moment to thank all of you who have served in the military, who are serving. So thank you. Please, everybody, give them a round of applause. We would not be here without you. And in June of 2022, well, who can forget? We opened the Cheech. And later in June of 2022, we secured historic levels of funding, $200 million of state funding for projects in our city. This major win for all Riversiders included funding for the historic Trujillo Adobe, the Cesar Chavez Community Center, the California Citrus State Historic Park, UC Riverside Campus Improvements, and the California School for the Deaf Riverside Sports Complex. And in August of 2022, our office launched the Campus Riverside Initiative to bring a greater awareness of job opportunities and professional networks to our local college students and graduates. Later in August, I launched an initiative called Beautify Riverside to lead community service projects and install public art and install pride in our city. And it was all privately funded. We are proud of the 9 community cleanups and 12 murals that we have across the city right now. Now, in September of 2022, I joined my fellow big city mayors and the governor in San Jose, California, for the historic signing of Care Court. This new legislation is a new tool that ushers in a way to help and treat severe mental illness. This is the first significant change in our state's mental health laws since 1967. And in October of 2022, we welcomed the Mission Heritage Plaza, which boasts affordable housing, right? And allocated housing for veterans and the Civil Rights Institute of Southern California. And in November of 2022, Riverside became the first city in the nation to partner with DoorDash to launch Project Dash, delivering food to people who are experiencing food insecurity. Since Project Dash's launch, our partner food pantries have delivered food to 7,000 people in need. And in December of 2022, the Mark had its grand opening in the downtown historic center, right on the corner of Market Street and Mission Inn Avenue. Now, Riverside continues to rise as the 12th largest city in California and the number one destination in the country for new residents over the last 2 years. And that's not the only recognition we've earned. Riverside is the number one city in North America with the greenest fleet of city vehicles. Fourth in the nation for using technology to improve delivery of City Services. And this one is particularly impressive. We are in the top 5% of the safest metropolitan areas in the country. Thank you, RPD. And we've installed more public art across the city this year than ever before. Okay. So now, we've done a lot over the past 2 years, and I'm extremely proud of all that work. My office and our city staff have been diligent and attentive to the needs of Riversiders, and we are determined to deliver tangible results alongside my colleagues on City Council. While we continue to confront the challenges of this year, we should always be thinking about and designing for tomorrow. And so we must focus on the priorities that are the cornerstone of every successful city: economic development, community well-being, education, finances, and our people. So let's start off with one of the highest priorities of my office and of the city's, and that is economic development. Now, you're going to see kind of a wonky definition. We often get asked, right, what is economic development? There's a definition here on the screen, but we'll just cut to the chase, and I'll point to the most important word there, and that word is intentional. We must be intentional to attract, grow, and keep businesses in Riverside, and we are doing just that. By having a stronger voice in regional and national issues. My recent appointment as vice chair of the Community and Economic Development Committee at the National League of Cities will give us access at the federal level to bring much needed dollars and affect policy. As well as my recent appointment as vice chair to the Southern California Association of Governments Community, Economic, and Human Development Committee, which positions Riverside at the table for regional resources. It's important that we have a voice in the region and the national level and the state, because that is the way Riverside will get its fair share. This year, we also launched our Coffee Chats with the Mayor. This series focuses on the needs of small business. We will be at local coffee shops across all the 7 wards throughout the city in 2023. And this is where you will have an opportunity to listen, learn, and share what is and is not working for businesses in the city. And good news for our business community. We're also ramping up with key hires from our new city manager, Mike Futrell, to our new Community and Economic Development Director, Jennifer Lilly, who's right here. And hot off the presses, we got a new Economic Development Manager, I think yesterday, right? I think Jorge Barrera is coming very soon. So these are important hires. And we continue to welcome new businesses. So I just want you to try to think in your mind, how many new business licenses do you think we issued last year? 23,000. 23,000 business licenses were issued last year. But even with these successes, we know we must continue to make Riverside an easier place to invest and do business. So this year, the city will embark on its comprehensive general plan update. This only happens once every 25 years. And this is the city's strategic long-range plan to guide growth to the year 2050. And most important, this will be your chance to weigh in on how we design Riverside's future. And of course, we aren't the City of Arts and Innovation for nothing. We have innovative entrepreneurs who are choosing Riverside Entrepreneurs like StarNav, a company focused on radio positioning technology. Photio, a kind of paint that mimics photosynthesis and combats greenhouse gases. Deep Bits, a different type of cybersecurity software. LV5A, a self-driving smart city hardware in the Innovation District. And finally, the Tech Steam Innovation Center. They all chose Riverside. Now, community well-being in any city requires investments in public safety. And I can't stress this enough. Ensuring our residents, businesses, and families are safe and have peace of mind is my highest priority, which is why the city continues to fully support, fund, and invest in our Riverside Police Department. Recent tragic events in Riverside County and the state have served as bitter reminders of how our sense of security can be shattered in an instant. So I want to thank our police and fire departments, as well as all of our first responders, for the sacrifices they make each day to keep us healthy and safe. Now, another foundational element to every successful city is a robust infrastructure. And during my tenure as mayor, we've allocated more dollars for infrastructure projects than in the last 15 years. In 2022, nearly 25 miles of roads were repaved. Nearly 160,000 square feet of new sidewalks installed, and 127,000 square feet of potholes repaired. And over 18,000 street trees were trimmed. And we are doubling down on that investment in this coming year. And Riverside Public Utilities led a citywide street replacement program that upgraded all overhead streetlights to LED illumination. As for 2023, we are not slowing down. Major sewer replacement projects are taking place in the western and central portions of the city, along with a slew of road repaving projects. I know that is music to all of your ears. A few of the arterial roads that will be repaved this year are Martin Luther King, Van Buren, California, Harupa, Olivewood, and La Sierra, along with numerous other collector roads in residential areas. No more bone-jarring rides. And let me just stop here for a moment, because I just want to say that it's not lost on me that all of these things that we're doing would not be possible without the 2016 approval of Measure Z. So thank you, Riverside voters, for saying yes to investing in our quality of life. Thank you. Now, beyond traditional infrastructure, we're making Riverside a modern digital city of the 21st century. A $300 million private investment from the company SiFi will deploy 9 million feet, that's almost 2,000 miles, of high-speed fiber internet citywide. This will bring broadband to every doorstep in our city, bridging the digital divide, dramatically increasing internet speeds in neighborhoods and for businesses. We are going to be the envy of every city in this country. This is just another way we are designing Riverside as a city of arts and innovation. Now let's talk a little bit about education. You know, Riverside is fortunate to have great educational institutions in our city. And designing a sustainable future means Riverside must foster an environment that builds and continues close partnerships with our universities and invests in the long-term development of our students. We can already see returns on these investments from each of our four higher ed institutions. All of them are elevating the impressive workforce pipeline here in Riverside by offering quality trade programs, providing vital business resources, tapping into our agricultural heritage with startup incubators, and innovating with renowned research operations. Our college institutions are preparing our students for real-world experiences by providing employers with endless talent. RCC, for instance, is making strides with their automotive program. Students work with potential employers such as Ford and Land Rover to learn automotive trade skills. And at Cal Baptist University, the JABS School of Business successfully launched the Family Business Center in partnership with the Economic Development Office. You know, small businesses are the lifeblood of any city, but especially ours, where we have a huge amount of family-owned businesses right here in Riverside. La Sierra University is supporting student entrepreneurship through their partnership with Enactus, an international nonprofit organization that empowers young entrepreneurs. And over at UCR, the School of Medicine is adding another building on an already expanding campus. And it's expected to be completed this summer. This new facility will house classrooms and lecture halls to support the academic research essential for maintaining a healthy economy and robust public health system. Now, tying all of this together, I mentioned this before, our Campus Riverside Initiative enables students to be competent workers and experts in their fields. Campus Riverside provides a one-stop shop for all things needed to incentivize recent and upcoming graduates to stay local by planting roots in the city where they received their education, just like their mayor. Now, I realize that none of this would be possible if our city was not financially stable. Stable finances are a critical component to running a successful city. And with the unpredictability of the past few years, it's really been a challenging journey. But with the fiscal resolve of our city, and of course the wise decision made by our residents in approving Measure Z, we are in a healthy financial position, I'm glad and happy to say tonight. General sales tax revenues have increased by over 30% since 2019. That's exceeding revised estimates from early this year. And Measure Z sales tax funding has also increased by 34% since 2019. And for the first time, the city has funded a $20 million infrastructure reserve account to address unfunded critical infrastructure needs throughout the city. So what does that all mean? Well, I think many of you know that the city had been operating in a reactive state due to strained financial resources. But now the city is operating in a more proactive fashion, taking a pragmatic approach that allows us to live within our means while maintaining city services and planning and designing for the future of Riverside. Now, pivoting to a different but equally important source of capital, social capital, our people. We often say we are a big city with a small town feel. And that is due to our community. We are a diverse city of faith-based organizations, businesses, nonprofits, and government. We are a city of families, college students, and retirees. We are a city of natives and transplants. But somehow, we all seem to be able to get along and make great things happen. That's Riverside. And we've often not been on the receiving end or getting the recognition that we deserve that's commensurate with our size and our significance at the federal, state level, whatever, you name it. Riverside's been out on its own. But the upshot of that is we've become incredibly self-sufficient and effective in our own ability to solve our own problems. When we have a problem here in Riverside, we roll up our sleeves. We enlist others in the community to help. We figure out what needs to be done, and we do it. Organizations like the Latino Network, the NAACP, Love Riverside, Sandals Church, the Raincross Group, the Riverside Arts Academy, Rivers and Lands Conservancy, and many, many more work together, sharing priorities and resources. And here's a good example of that I'll share with you. So last year, in last year's address, I proposed something I call the Civil Rights Walk to link the six memorials on our Main Street Mall that tell the stories of local and international struggle and perseverance. That would be the first of its kind. Now, each one of those statues started with an individual community group who then worked together with the larger community to raise funds and realize their vision. And now, I'm excited to say tonight that that landmark Civil Rights Walk is closer than ever to becoming a reality. The Riverside County Transportation Commission has recommended $2.6 million in grant funding to better connect these statues and numerous other cultural sites with a linked 1.8-mile pathway and unifying signage to better tell our story and draw visitors to other experiences in downtown, such as the Cheech, the Mission Inn, the Civil Rights Institute, all part of the rich cultural experiences that Riverside offers the world. And it is our people that are making all this happen. Truly, truly, truly our most valuable asset here in Riverside. Now, we cherish that small town feel, right? Even though, don't know if many of you know this, we are larger. Riverside is larger than 99% of all cities in the United States. We are in the top 1% of cities by population size. We are a big city here. We have a healthy business community, a growing college-age population, and exciting new developments. But I did not run for mayor of Riverside to just be good. I ran because I believed Riverside should expect excellence. And my good friend, Rose Mays, recently reminded me that Riverside is doing good, but it is time for Riverside to be great. So let's propel Riverside to greatness. We are no longer, this one drives me nuts, I'm sure you've all heard this, we are no longer a city that is close to everything, right? We are a city that has everything. We have it here in Riverside. Where everyone has what they need to be happy, to be safe, to do business, be financially secure, and be hopeful about the future. But what does it take to go from good to great? Well, like all things in life, it won't be easy, but it is worth doing. Because Riverside is ready. And it takes disciplined people, disciplined thought, and disciplined action to make that change. So let's start with the first one, disciplined people. So tonight, I want to call on our next level of leaders to step up and begin their service by joining a board or commission here in Riverside. We need you to participate. There's hard work ahead, but I believe in this city, this Riverside we call home, and I know we're up to the challenge. And while we're well on our way to building a team of disciplined people, we must deploy disciplined thought in our approach. And we do this by being honest with ourselves. and confronting the brutal facts. I'm not going to sugarcoat this. In our last quality of life survey that many of you responded to, 88% of our respondents called homelessness the number one issue facing the city. I heard it throughout my big tent tour. I hear it from our business community. I hear it from our residents. I hear you. Yes, it is a national and a statewide crisis that has been decades in the making. But we're responsible for what happens here in Riverside. Now, this issue did not become a crisis overnight, and it's not going to get solved overnight. Solutions are going to come in increments as we work to correct 40 years of poor policies and decisions and social issues. And we will continue to balance the need for increased public safety with the need for services. Yes, we all have rights, but we all have responsibilities too. Our approach must continue to reflect both these realities. We have a clear strategy to address homelessness based on data. And we've employed a plan to address all facets of this very complicated issue as directed by you, our residents, such as in our parks and neighborhoods. You know, city parks are where residents go to relax, where kids go to play. And to ensure they can be enjoyed, we've invested in a new team of park and neighborhood specialists who will help our police. And they will oversee 58 parks spanning nearly 3,000 acres in the city. Now, our commitment to public safety hasn't wavered, because in early 2019, we allocated $3 million in Measure Z money to create the Public Safety and Engagement Teams, or PSET. I was out with them yesterday morning doing the point in time count. This multidisciplinary team has been incredibly effective in maintaining safety and cleanliness in our public places while offering services to those who need it. Over this last fiscal year, they have responded to nearly 5,000 locations in our city. 5,000. That's led to multiple contacts with homeless encampments, resulting in 800 individuals accepting services and over 400 arrests. And incredibly, almost 350 tons of trash removed. So know that those PSET teams are an investment that is providing returns. And the city now welcomes a new public safety engagement team dedicated to the protection of our wildland spaces, such as the Santa Ana River bottom, Whole Lake, and Sycamore Canyon. Fire risk in these wildlands areas has dramatically increased for a number of reasons that include drying conditions and also homeless encampments too. This is not acceptable. It's not acceptable. And I reject the notion that it's inhumane to enforce laws to prevent these kinds of encampments. The reality is, it is inhumane to let people languish in conditions that are unfit for any human. PSET will enforce the laws to protect the lives and safety of not only those who live in these areas, but also the residents and businesses nearby. Now, locally, we've created a homeless action plan which identifies specific goals for housing, services, emergency shelter, and regional coordination. And just last week, I heard from the director of the Interagency Council on Homelessness that it is one of the best in the nation, and he's seen a lot of them. This homeless action plan makes one point clear. We will no longer invest in the status quo. We are having a much different conversation now than we were 3 years ago. We've signed a memorandum of understanding with the county to coordinate our efforts in the Santa Ana River Bottom and increase security at facilities like the County Emergency Treatment Services. And last week, the City Council approved Project Connect to connect those leaving the county jail with services, increasing the coordination between the sheriff and our nonprofit partner, Victory Outreach. And statewide, we've been instrumental in the passage of Care Court, which updates our state's mental health laws. And with this piece of legislation, finally, family members and care providers will be empowered to help individuals suffering from acute mental health challenges to finally get the care they need. In Riverside County, because of our advocacy, will be among the first counties in the state to implement Care Court by the fall of this year. These actions position us to address homelessness in new and significant ways in the coming year, but we cannot take our foot off the gas, obviously. More work to do. We will do better because the next generation of Riversiders are depending on us. Now, I don't have to tell you that the best way to address homelessness is to prevent it in the first place. And did you know that foster youth, aged out foster youth, are at particularly increased risk of becoming homeless? More than 1 in 4 of our nation's youth and young adults who have no home reside in California. 1 in 4. And 78% of those young people are unsheltered, with little or no access to services to make a permanent transition off the streets, out of poverty, and into a stable livelihood. And since 2018, the number of youth experiencing homelessness in Riverside has steadily increased. This too is unacceptable. Many of you out there are parents. I'm a parent. No young person should have to worry about where they're going to sleep tonight or shelter when they should be worrying about tests and studying or becoming a member of our workforce. So our community is doing something about it. We're providing more affordable housing, such as the Aspire Housing Development, and that's exclusively for aged out foster youth. And I mentioned our newly launched Job Corps, which will enable us to construct a pipeline to self-sufficiency for disadvantaged youth who need a job and lack the resources to secure one. Youth homelessness is solvable in Riverside, and we must seize this moment to confront this issue head on. So that's why tonight I am officially launching the Mayor's Challenge to End Youth Homelessness here in the city of Riverside. Partnering with the county and school districts, we have a plan to meet our goal of ending youth homelessness. Now, I know what you're thinking. Is this goal achievable? Is she nuts? Well, that's another conversation. And the answer is yes. Yes, it is solvable. We did it for our homeless veterans, and now we can do it for our youth. Let's talk about the last element of our progress, disciplined action. We need disciplined action to move the city forward. We need to be intentional, there's that word again, intentional in our approaches. And here's a plan. I always have like a 10-point plan where I do things, but I'll just let you know the disciplined action that we need to do to take our city forward. 1, we must be laser focused on job growth and economic development. 2, we must make sure everyone understands Riverside is open for business. 3, we must leverage our existing relationships with companies to maintain and grow their presence here. We must focus on small businesses. We must attract capital investment and connect startups with financing. We must encourage investment in our city, and we must market that effort nationally and internationally. And we must ensure our city is beautiful, clean, and welcoming, with high-quality entertainment and recreational opportunities. These things are very important. Now, having owned a small business for 20 years, I've had my fair share of challenges, and I know many of you out there are business owners, and you have challenges too. Let me be clear, I just want you to know, as long as I'm your mayor, you'll have someone fighting to ensure you have the resources to overcome those challenges and succeed in this city. As your mayor, I'm putting my experience into disciplined action. These three pillars of disciplined people, disciplined thought, and disciplined action are what we need to move Riverside forward toward greatness. And I know it may be really difficult to imagine how we're going to achieve all this, but here's the difference. We're not just envisioning a future. We're not just hoping for one. As you know, hope is not a strategy. We're not planning for one. We are going to design it by taking actionable steps to deliver a better Riverside. And in front of you, on your tables, I'm going to tell you how you can do it. You can be part of it. In front of you on your tables is your program. And on the back of that program is a QR code. Now you can scan that QR code, and it'll lead you to a page where you can enter your information and learn how you can take action. Tomorrow, I'll send you an email listing the ways that you can help determine how our future of Riverside is designed for Riverside by Riverside. But before we leave tonight, I just want us to reflect a little bit on why we're here. We're here because we have a common desire to see this city we love continue to be a shining beacon of excellence. I was born and raised in this city. I met my husband, and later had three beautiful children. Never in my wildest dreams would I would have thought that I would become the mayor of my hometown. Never. But every day, every day, every day, every day, I work towards creating a better Riverside that will be left behind for all of our children. And I know many of you share that sentiment. And now it is within our power to design a city that we and the next generation of Riversiders can be proud of. You've heard it said many times before. Riverside is unique. We're special. But that didn't just happen randomly. It was by design. For you see, we are a city that rejects the partisan politics that divide us and cripples progress. We are a city that values our businesses and furthers the arts. We are a city that is hopeful about the future, but cherishes our past. And while we are a city that is intentionally planned for innovation, we are also a city thoughtfully steeped in tradition. Because in the end, we're all working toward a common goal, a Riverside designed for all of us, because we are Riverside. Thank you, everybody. Have a good night. Thank you.